X-ray tube head and production of X-rays. The X-ray machine has three main components: the X-ray tube head, the extension arm, and the control panel. The dental X-ray tube, where the X-rays are produced, is located inside this X-ray tube head. The dental X-ray tube has a negatively charged cathode, a positively charged anode, and the glass tube is completely evacuated. It is made of leaded glass tube, and a portion of the glass tube is made of unleaded glass window to allow the passage of X-rays that are produced. The cathode has a filament made of tungsten and a focusing cup made of molybdenum. It has a tungsten target and a copper stem. The cathode of the dental X-ray tube is connected to a step-down transformer, which is used to decrease the line voltage to heat the filament to emit the electrons. The electrons thus produced are said to have produced by thermionic emission. The anode of the X-ray tube is connected to step-up transformer. It is used to increase the line voltage to attract the electrons to anode. Another transformer used is auto transformer. It is used to manage minor fluctuations of voltage in the circuit. So, when the X-rays are produced, a high energy short wavelength X-rays are produced and low energy long wavelength X-rays are produced. The X-ray tube and all the transformers are immersed in an insulating oil, which insulates the heat produced in the X-ray tube from transmitting outside the X-ray tube head. This insulating oil is encased in a metal tube housing. Now, the metal tube housing is completely covered except for a small part for permitting the X-rays produced to exit the X-ray tube head. So, this part has to be sealed so that there is no leakage of insulating oil. So, this is sealed with the help of tube head seal. So, tube head seal allows the insulating oil not to leak from the X-ray tube. Now, we've said that two types of energies are produced, that is, the long wavelength low energy and the short wavelength high energy. The long wavelength low energy X-rays are absorbed in the patient and are harmful for the patient. So we have to filter this and allow only the short wavelength to reach the patient. So we add something called as filters. The aluminium disc filters the low energy long wavelength X-rays and allows only the short wavelength high energy X-rays to pass through the X-ray tube head. At 70 kVp, a thickness of 1.5 mm of aluminium filters are used, and above 70 kVp we use 2.5 mm thickness of aluminium. Now, we know that the X-rays cannot be focused and are always divergent. So, in order to resize and reshape the X-rays, we use something called as collimators. So, collimators are added in the X-ray tube so as to reduce the size and shape of the X-rays that exit out of the X-ray tube head. Now we need to add something called as position indicating device. This is a cylinder which helps to aim the X-rays towards the patient. Self-assessment for the students.